last question. Never think of consequences. I didn't feel a thing. I didn't feel a thing. I never think twice, no intentions. Never feel the consequences. Until it starts to sting. Until it starts to sting.
Hey guys, Legendary Ghidorah here, and yeah, let's begin here. Supreme's human name is known as Ethan Crane, and he got his powers from a meteor made of Supremium. You know, it was pretty weird. He had a pretty weird comic run. So yeah, he gained these incredible powers from a meteor called Supremium. So, you know, you don't get any of that Superman origin type of stuff here. I guess you would say he's more of a sentry kind of character, him getting his powers from another worldly source, or pretty much a Superman version of Vandal Savage, who got his powers from a meteor as well. So today here, we're going to be scaling him and just seeing how powerful he really is. And, well, gotta say he's done some pretty impressive things. For starters, one of his first few feats I like to go over is like the fact that this dude actually was able to push a continent with his bare hands. Back in those days, I'm pretty sure it was pretty weird comic days. I mean, pretty was looked like a Looney Tune in my opinion. So yeah, Supreme was doing some pretty good stuff. He's flown through planets, escaped the pull of a black hole. But I think one of his more impressive feats, in my opinion, is him being able to hold his own in a hand one-on-one conflict with a gladiator. I think that's pretty much more impressive than anything he's done. And if you guys want to scale him, he's above Suprema, the female version of him, who has, I think, been able to hold a universe in her hands, or if I recall correctly. So yeah, she's definitely below him when it comes to power, and you know, he's actually been confirmed to be above her and more powerful than her. So yeah, let's talk about his gladiator confrontation. That's actually one of the more impressive feats, considering Gladiator is pretty much a Herald level character, and it's pretty much one of Marvel's, in my opinion, better versions of Superman any day of the week here. I mean, this guy is basically Superman with a combination of, I guess I could say, like, General Zod. I don't know. Supreme feels more like a Zod kind of character, to me, in my opinion. So, honestly, it was pretty impressive. He held his own against Gladiator in a hand-to-hand fight. Now, how strong is Gladiator? Well, if you guys saw my How Powerful is Gladiator video, this guy's been able to go toe-to-toe with characters like the Destroyer Armor, a character who can fight Celestials. Also has been able to go toe-to-toe with Hulk, someone who's destroyed universes with his bare hands. And has been able to, routinely beat the crap out of Thor. I mean, that's a character who's been able to go toe-to-toe with Skyfather beings and crack Celestial armor. So I think it's safe to say here that, Supreme is definitely on that kind of caliber, okay? When it comes to speed, he's been able to react in nanoseconds, has been able to casually escape the pull of a black hole, has been able to, you know, casually fly into outer space with ease, and has performed many faster-than-light feats over his career, even being able to ram through an entire planet within the blink of an eye. So yeah, he's definitely faster to the speed of light. Immeasurable speeds, I would have to say yes, because again, this dude kept up with Gladiator in a hand-to-hand fight. Gladiator being a character who routinely is able to cross galaxies within the blink of a god eye, and was able to blitz Heimdall and get a foothold in Asgard as well. So yeah, I have to say that he's definitely comparable, definitely around the same tier as Gladiator. Maybe, I don't know. I wouldn't put him definitely on the same tier, but he's definitely, you know, around the same levels as characters like Hyperion, Gladiator, and maybe even the likes of Blue Marvel and Sentry, at least when it comes to terms of strength and durability. And I mean, this guy is pretty impressive. He's taking planetary explosions, nuclear bombs, pretty much everything that Earth could throw at him. He's even taken attacks from Suprema, who again can hold a universe in her hands. I mean, really, it's just ridiculously impressive, you guys. Suprema also possesses heat vision. He's been able to keep up with Gladiator in a beam battle. Actually, was able to put Gladiator in a temporal beam struggle. So yeah, he does possess heat vision that would compare to, again, Gladiator, who's, again, if you watch my video, who's been able to routinely match Phoenix Force users in energy projection, burns hotter than a star, and is able to injure the Hulk, okay? So what makes Supreme really special? What separates him from other Superman, you know, copycats or rip-offs or whatever you guys like to say? So what makes Supreme different is pretty much more of his attitude and pretty much his origin, honestly. I mean, this guy was pretty much an ordinary farm boy. They got his powers from a meteor. So honestly, I think that should definitely separate him from the likes of Superman. So yeah, I'd say here that So Supreme is definitely looking pretty strong here. I mean, in this fight with Gladiator, this also does show he has levels of hand-to-hand skill, because you can't fight Gladiator without no hand-to-hand skill at all. Now, you might say, he's lost to the Hulk. Come on now, Legendary. What's wrong with you? You're just wanking Gladiator. Like, come on now. You can't be doing that. Like, Hulk has hand-to-hand skill. He's got some hand-to-hand combat. He's been trained by S.H.I.E.L.D. in some incarnations. Has spent his years in a Gladiator pit on Sakaar. So definitely Hulk does know how to fight. Okay? So yeah, I gotta say that, yeah, you can't just downplay Gladiator's hand-to-hand combat skill because, what, he lost to Hulk? I mean, lots more skilled people have lost to Hulk as well. That's because he knows what he's doing. I mean, Hercules, Better A Bill, Thor, can keep going. So honestly here, you guys, I have to put Supreme definitely at a universal level. I mean, you know, at max potential, definitely universal. At least, well, max potential in the standard comic sense, not, you know, scaling sense. Because some characters do scale to autoversal, hyperversal, megaversal, omniversal. You know, they scale to those types of setting. Okay, so when it honestly push comes to shove, yeah, I have to say here that Supreme is genuinely a real good character. Real good character. His attitude definitely reflects he possesses the other senses, like of any other Superman character. He's got super hearing. He's been able to hear objects from light years away, been able to scan things down to a molecular level, actually views the world on a molecular level, which actually should give him a upper hand if he's going up against someone like Rayquaza, Android 17, or even Ben 10. So honestly, this should give him an edge here when it comes to, well, even combat. He can view his opponent on a molecular level, decipher what they are, what they can do, and then, boom, take them, or at least, you know, do what he can against them. He was also possesses, you know, the same powers as any other Superman copycat. Freeze breath. He's actually used his super breath to actually bench press a tank. And that was pretty much him just, you know, goofing around with his day. So yeah, at the end of the day here, Supreme's attitude of not caring and being a ruthless character definitely should help him in this kind of fight. I definitely think I think he's probably the second strongest member on the Image Comics team. I'll probably put, maybe Pitt above him, and then he would definitely be stronger than Invincible by a huge, and I mean a huge margin. So, yeah, I have to say here that Supreme is definitely might be stronger than Pitt, maybe. I don't know. We'll get to the Pitt video soon. He'll be the next Image character that I present here. Probably tomorrow, but I'll definitely be working on him tonight. Okay? The next one will definitely go over the, Invincible character as well. As I have read Invincible Comics, he is a pretty interesting character. After the episode survived with his guts ripped out, and I actually think Supreme would definitely need that kind of attitude on his team. And, Pitt as well is a pretty ruthless and insanely dangerous character, okay? So I have to say here that at the end of the day, Supreme is definitely on the same footing as characters like Gladiator, Silver Surfer, Better Ray Bill, Hyperion, probably, Hyperion 130, 34, definitely would have to put him up there as well. And yeah, I definitely have to say here that Supreme definitely lives up to his name. I know that's corny, but you guys get my point, right? So let me know what you guys think down below. Please comment, like, and subscribe, and share with your friends. This is Legendary Ghidorah, and I hope you guys are having a blessed day during this pandemic, and well, doing what you guys do best. Please share, like, and comment, or don't. I hope you guys watched this video, and this is Legendary Ghidorah, and I will see you guys later. Peace.